In previous episodes of this Cloud Workflow series, we had a look at how to define data structures like arrays. We also learned about jumps, how to move between steps, expressions. And with all this, we can actually do something interesting, which is iterating over the values of an array. And for example, call a different API with the different values in the array. First of all, we need to define some variables. So let's say you want to do a loop over the content of an array. We'll call it array. For example, I'm going to put Google Cloud Workflows. We'll concatenate actually those values in a string. And since we're doing an iteration, I'm going to need some kind of index value. The first thing to do is to define a check condition. We'll do a switch over a particular condition. The condition will be like in a for loop in a programming language. If I, the current index, is less than the length of the array. Notice the len built-in function. Then if the condition is true, next we're going to go to the iterate state. If not, if the switch condition is not met, because that's the end of the loop, we're going to go to the end state, which we'll call return result. So let's see what the iteration looks like. Again, we need to do some variable assignment. So the result, we'll use an expression to define the result. Result, the previous value of results in the iteration, we'll actually append the current item in the array, and we'll add some space. And we also need to increment our index. So we're going to use expressions again for that. I plus 1 goes into 1. And the next step will be to go back to check condition. If the condition is not met, we're at the end of the loop. And we're going to go to the last step, because that's the step that is mentioned here in the next step. And we're going to return the result. And again, we use an expression. Let's deploy this and let's execute this. Google Cloud Workflows. Now you can create some quite complex workflows. You can iterate over values of APIs, of arrays, etc. Congrats!